Doing different triggers with items that I've used to decorate my room. So let's get into the video. This skeleton that I found at the Dollar Tree. Well, found's not quite the right word. I saw someone else have it, and I went out of my way to find it. Like 5 different stores, to be exact. From the Dollar Tree. The skull is a Halloween item, this one is fall. I actually got 3. I got the white one, a orange one, and a reddish orange one. I think the white one fits the aesthetic of this video more though. Oh, this is one of those baby food jars. I like cleaned out afterwards, and I like to put things in these. The little plinking sound is an earring. Oops. This is kind of a sad story, but oh well, the story is stuck in here. It's not supposed to be there, but I'd gotten this pair of earrings from my grandma, who unfortunately passed away, and they were my favorite pair. And one of them fell out of my ear, and I was unable to find it because I was outside. So I either dropped it in a parking lot somewhere. I have no idea, but I just keep the one in here now. And I actually have another jar like this with even more. So these are little origami stars. That I made. I'll have to do a video of me making them. Because they're a lot of fun. They're really simple. And I got a whole pack in like every single color and every shade. So I like to put my favorites together. I have this in a little 1960s cream bottle that it was $4.50 for a glass bottle. Yeah. Not my smartest purchase, but it's very cute and I actually like the writing. So, more. These I did not make. One of my best friends did, and she's actually the one who taught me how to make these. And she makes these little jars for everybody for Christmas, birthdays, etc. She makes them for her teachers. She usually makes them, you know, before you kind of party. heart. It's like at the end of the school year, she'd make up for teachers. Her friends, she didn't think she'd see anymore. I'll be honest, we don't talk that often anymore because we go to different schools. I do still text her sometimes when I miss her. And this is her sweet little, like, going away gift/birthday gift. My birthday was quite literally the day of, like, graduation. So, graduation gift, birthday gift, all in one. I do like the plastic is nice. Another Dollar Tree find. I like this one a lot. It's a little spaceship. It's a very pretty color. It blends in with my shirt. Different texture. Again, Dollar Tree. It's like a... It looks like an anchovy. I think my friend said it looked like a cabbage. It's like a little... Don't really like the sound that makes me scratch it, I'll be honest. Fizzes up all the way, but also this one's good when you spray it. This is actually a hair perfume, so it's meant to be sprayed on hair. And it's a very, like, subtle, light scent. It's chamomile rose. Very messy, but I love this little book. It is so cute. I got it at this little book sales, and it's Uncommon Wisdom. Read this for a video at one point because it was pretty much like all quotes from famous authors and stuff like that. You see the little cute little drawings and the tiny little writing, and that's just the whole book. I like to just pick this up and read this sometimes. Now, I got this photo frame a long time ago. I've had it since I was little. I remember having a little photo of me and one of my, like, elementary school friends in it. But I drew this little drawing of a butterfly, and I wrote the quote, "Happiness is a butterfly." This is one of my favorite quotes. When I would actually like tattooed, I want a butterfly tattooed with that written underneath it. Not a color tattoo though, and I want the butterfly to be more detailed than that, but You get the gist. I love the sound of textured glass. Makes my nails so funny. This is actually a photo of my mom and my grandma, two of the most important women in my life. Fortunately, this is the grandma who passed away, but should never not be my favorite. I actually want to get quite a few tattoos in her honor as well. I have a lot of cards that she used to send me, always with a sweet little message and signature, so it wouldn't be hard to, you know, find something in her handwriting. I have quite a bit in mind. Of course, I'm going to narrow it down. She used to say "this too shall pass" a lot, but that's, I hear that phrase so often, and like those little motivational quote things, I don't know how I feel about it. Now this is an empty photo frame. I actually wanted to put a photo of my grandma in it though. I've worn it in mind in particular. I remember when she was still alive, we were on our way somewhere, and my neighbors had like this yellow flower tree, and I told her to stand under it, because I thought it would be a pretty picture, and my mom's actually the one who took the picture. So it's a photo of my grandma taken by my mom. That was my idea, and it was a really pretty photo. And now that she's passed away, I'd really like to have it in here. Well, there's another photo of my mom and my grandma that I really like. I would just need my own copy, because I'd have to cut it to fit. It's a square, and I'm not going to do that to the original copy. And there's another picture. My dad and my mom and me as a baby. I love the little watering can. Yeah. These are the only two, like, photos that I took with me. Although I intend to have the third. Here's another book. Another one that I would like to read in the video. It's Cats in Spring Rain, a celebration of feline charm and Japanese art of haiku. So it's basically haiku poems about cats. I even have a cute little one on the back too. Remember, I got this very recently. Oh, I was at an art museum and they had it in the gift shop. That's where I got it. Last but not least, this little painting that I did. My dorm likes to do these, bonding exercise things, and they did a Bob Ross paint night. I did not follow the Bob Ross tutorial, I just did my own thing. I did like an ombre from pink to purple to blue, clouds, moon, and stars. Gonna be it.